Team Jimmy Lombo.
Hey!
So Gary, can you give me your thoughts on today's game, please?
Well, a disappointing first half performance. We never put Stranraer under enough pressure when they had the ball in terms of, you know, winning it back. So we can get possession of the ball, because we've got players in the dressing room with the ball that can go and win games. We've got match winners in there. The first half we never done that, but going into the second half, we changed the shape of the team. We pressed the ball better, and I think throughout the second half that we put in a, you know, a much better performance.
The goal changed things, didn't it, for Andy Ryan's strike?
Oh yeah, that's what Andy's capable of. You know, he gets the ball in an area, a good flick for Swanks, and he has a good early strike which catches the keeper out. But that's what Andy is capable of, and that's why we've brought him here. It's an area that we're short in at the moment. We've been seeking another striker over the past couple of weeks. We thought we were close on a couple of occasions. Again, we thought we were going to have somebody playing today, didn't work out. But it's an area that we know we're looking to strengthen, as we've only got sort of one recognised striker in the squad, and hopefully for next week that we can add and bring somebody in to add to the quality we've already got here.
Did the difference from prior to the goal and then once the goal was scored, the heads did seem to go up a bit. Does that just highlight the main problem here, maybe is confidence more than anything else just now?
I think the first half I'm not saying we weren't competitive, but we weren't competitive enough. The second half we went out and we competed a lot better. We matched Stranraer in the areas all over the park, you know, and that we managed to get the goal, which I think we deserved in the second half. And I think just that eagerness and willingness to go and press the ball and go and win it back, and it helps you massively in games that when you've not got it, you can't do anything. But you've got to have the ball to score goals. In the second half, I felt we'd done that much better than we did in the first half.
Mm-hmm. That was a good performance in the end. Disappointed maybe with 10 men that...
It was a short period with 10 men, you know, the one that came across the face of the goals that I think Andy Ryan and I think it was Ewan Spark who were in there, you know, another day it might have went, it was similar to the Stranraer goal, but fortunately for them we got a lock and theirs went in. Yeah. Our luck at this stage of the season, it's not happening for us at times, and theirs didn't go in, but it might happen for us next week.
Are you happy with the way things are going and the progress you're seeing each week? Are you happy?
Well, it's been a hard period coming in. The players have gone through a period of time where they've not won a lot of games, so confidence has been low, but hopefully, you know, that we're getting them back in a confident mood at the moment. Training's been good. The second half performance today we can take a lot of positives from, but we've got to, you know, take that to next week up to Peterhead, because we're in it's a real difficult game up there, and you know, everybody will need to be at the top of their game next week to come back with an end for them.
There's no easy games now, is there?
There's no easy games, you know, every game's a cup final for us. We've got 16 I think it was 16 today, 15 now. That we've got to roll the sleeves up, dig in, and get as many points as we can on the board to get out the playoff spot that we're in at the moment. Lads in there are desperate to do that, and as a coaching staff, we're the same. And you know, we'll be getting our all to get out that second bottom spot to avoid that playoff spot at the end of the season.
Great. And just finally, you say you're hoping to bring somebody in. Have you got one or two options, or?
We've had a couple of options. I spoke to somebody that was hopeful we'd get them before the window closed on Monday night. Fortunately, the player we're speaking to is a free agent at the moment. He's got other options as well that he's weighing up, so we've allowed him a bit of time to get back to us. But there was another one that, you know, that may have been played today, but things never happened the way we wanted them to. So it's an area we know that we're a bit short at the moment. Goals, we need goals. We need a striker that's going to score us maybe 10 goals between now and the end of the season. Andy will help us with that, but we need to get some support to him, and that's the reason why we're trying to, you know, bring a new face in as a forward at the moment.
Well, all the best for that.
Cheers, thank you. Cheers,
Andy Ryan, thanks. You're the sponsors, man of the match today. How did you feel the game went?
I thought the first half we were poor, to say the least. We were second to every second ball. The passing wasn't there. We were just kind of playing it long, and then we came in at half time, and the gaffer kind of dogged for us and kind of asked us a question. Have we got anything about us? And I think for that second half performance, we gave a response. I thought we were in their faces. I thought we played well. I thought we created a few chances. And then on another day, we could have maybe scored and maybe nicked it at the end there. I've got a wee chance at the end. But we'll take a point, and then it's a starting point.
It was a tough game today because they're a form side at the moment, Stranraer. So it was a tough game. So you're happy just to take a point?
I think the way the game went, I think we'd probably be happy with a point, but I think when we go into games, we want to get all 3 points because we're kind of down at the bottom of the league, and we kind of want to pull away for the teams below us, but we want to kind of try and catch the teams above us. But Nostrona are a good team. They kind of get the ball down, like to pass it. They've got a few diagonals and they've got a few good experienced players in their team. So overall, I think a point was maybe a fair result.
On a personal level now, you scored a really good goal today. Could you talk us through that goal? Or what you remember?
I think the first half, I was kind of up there in my own. And I thought when I was kind of flicking things on, it was kind of going nowhere. But fair play to the gaffer, half time, he recognised that and put Swanks up front with me. And I just kind of got a wee flick on it to Swanks. And then maybe in the first half, that kind of maybe go through to nobody. But with the two up top, I think it kind of went to him and he's played it back out of the corner. I just took a touch and I just kind of put my boot through it and looked at it in.
Did you know as soon as you hit it, it was a goal?
I think it's one of the connections, and it leaves your boot, you've kind of got a fair idea that it's going in the back of the net, and then lucky for me, it kind of saw it out the back of the net.
What's that feeling like to score a goal?
That's what you kind of, when you're a young kid, that's what you want to do in it, score goals, and it's a great feeling just to score goals, and especially getting aside a point. But overall, I think that second half performance, we need to keep that up. We kind of just start at half time, we need to kind of start for the first whistle. So we'll kind of take the positives into the next game, and then it's got to be another tough game, but we'll go up there and give it our best shot.
Well, you're off and running now with your goals, so congratulations, and you are today's sponsors, man of the match, so thanks for your time, and congratulations, Andy.
Thanks very much. Thanks.